We've looked at how letter tiles online can be used to teach phonemic awareness and phonics. Now let's look at how it can be used to teach morphology. With the prefix and suffix letter tiles, you can easily teach students how to decode affixes and demonstrate how affixes affect a word's meaning. Remember, we use the More Tiles menu to access additional tiles. Let's use the Prefixes and Suffixes menu to grab some prefixes. I'll open up the Prefix submenu, but instead of moving all the prefixes up to the Today's Tiles menu, I'll just bring up the Pre, Re, and Mis tiles. I'm also going to open up the Vowel Spellings menu and grab one of the long E spellings, EA. First, we'll spell the word read with letter tiles, R-E-A-D. We can use touch and say to read the word read, R-E-D. Now we'll see what happens to that base word when I add a prefix. First, I'll add the prefix pre. All of the letters that form a prefix or suffix are on one tile since they work together to represent one affix. At this point, I would discuss the meaning of the prefix pre with my students. It means to do something before something else. Then I'd read the prefix and the base word and combine them to read the whole word. I'll touch the prefix tile and say pre. I want to remind the students that they should try to recognize prefixes as chunks. I'll read the rest of the word, read, pre, read, pre-read. I would then discuss how this prefix changes the meaning of the base word it's attached to. Pre-read means to skim through and read parts of a text before reading the whole thing. I might ask my students to think of other words that have the prefix pre, like preheat or preview. I'll drag the pre tile over the trash can icon to remove it, and now let's pull down our next prefix tile, re. I'll begin by discussing the meaning of the prefix re. Re means to do something again. I'll demonstrate how to read the prefix by touching the tile while saying re. Then I'll read the base word, read. Now let's combine them to read the whole word. Re, read, re-read. We'll demonstrate how the prefix re changed the meaning of the base word read by explaining that this new word means to read something again. Students can think of other words that have the prefix re, like redo, reform, or renew. Let's remove the re tile by dropping it over the trash can icon, and now let's pull down the prefix tile miss. First, we'll discuss the meaning of the prefix miss. It means to do something incorrectly. We'll touch the prefix tile and read the prefix miss. Then we'll read the base word, read. Combining the prefix and the base word, we can read the whole word. Miss, read, misread. I'll explain how the prefix changes the meaning of the base word read. To misread something means to read it incorrectly. Now let's see how the online letter tiles can be used to teach suffixes. I'll clear the main board and the Today's Tiles area by clicking on the eraser icons. Let's go back to our More Tiles menus and get some suffix tiles. The suffix tiles are broken up into four submenus: vowel suffixes, consonant suffixes, inflectional suffixes, and sounds of the suffix ed. I want to get two consonant suffixes and one vowel suffix. I'll grab the tile er from the vowel suffixes submenu and the tiles full and less from the consonant suffixes submenu. We can easily teach students the difference between vowel and consonant suffixes with the virtual letter tiles. First, let's spell out the word help with letter tiles. H-E-L-P. We'll use touch and say to read the word. H-E-L-P. Help. Now let's add a consonant suffix to help. Explain that a consonant suffix is a suffix that begins with a consonant letter. Tell students that we can touch the suffix full and remind them that they should read this suffix as a chunk. When we read the consonant suffix full at the end of the word help, we get the word helpful. We can read the base word help and the suffix full and then combine them, helpful. The consonant suffix full means full of, and it changes the meaning of the word help. We can teach students that the new word helpful means full of help, and it describes someone who is always trying to help others. Students can think of other words that have the suffix "ful," like thoughtful or forgetful.
We can introduce other consonant suffixes by switching out the suffix "ful" and adding the suffix "less." When we add the consonant suffix "less" to "help," we get "helpless." I'll explain that the suffix "less" means without, and that the meaning of the word "helpless" is having no help. Introducing other words like "thankless," "senseless," or "humorless" can help students understand the meaning of the suffix "less." Let's shift from consonant suffixes to vowel suffixes. I'll get rid of the suffix "less" by dropping it over the trash can icon, and I'll bring down the vowel suffix "er." I'll start by explaining to students that a vowel suffix is a suffix that begins with a vowel letter. We can touch the tile "er" and read the suffix "er." If we add the vowel suffix "er" to the word "help," we get "helper." I'll teach the students that the suffix "er" can turn a verb into a noun. So the verb "help" becomes a noun that means a person who helps when we add the suffix "er."
Now we'll clear the main board. If your students need more help distinguishing vowel suffixes from consonant suffixes, you can bring multiple vowel and consonant suffix tiles up to today's tiles and have students help you sort the suffixes into two columns, vowel suffixes on one side and consonant suffixes on the other. I might make a column of vowel suffixes under the "er" tile and a column of consonant suffixes under the "less" tile. We hope this video has been useful in showing some of the many ways you can easily use the online letter tiles to teach students not only how to decode affixes, but also how to use the meanings of these affixes to determine the meaning of an unknown word.